to find our way to the control center from here.
Good luck. Full hammer out.
Hey guys, what's going on? It is the Tyrant here, and we are back with the final mission that is currently available from the CMT community regarding Halo Combat Evolved Single Player Version 3. This has been an excellent mod to play so far. Today we are doing the mission Assault on the Control Room. As you can see, like with the... Whoa, okay, rockets from the Pelican. Wasn't really expecting that. It's awesome, just make sure you don't walk in front of that door. Just like with the last couple of missions, you have a choice as to what loadout is available to you at the start of the mission. So I chose Saboteur, just like I did with the last mission. The Silent Cartographer. I wanted to say the Pillar of Autumn, I don't know why. Just because I really love the silenced SMG, and I really also like the battle rifle with the grenade launcher option. I think that's pretty awesome. Weapon. Unfortunately, in this mission, unlike in the last two, there are no recharge stations. So, unfortunately, you cannot get yourself infinite grenades. I've already played through this mission one time, as you can probably see from my sneak peek video. So, I already went through hunting, seeing if maybe it was there. I figured if any mission could use it, it would be this one. But, unfortunately, we've got to go through this the fair and square way. Now, I will say one minor annoyance I have with this mission, not with CMT's version of it, just this mission in general, is these little circular rooms. I went back and counted, and there's 12 of them. That seems a little excessive, considering how long this mission really is. Fortunately, the additions that CMT added were outdoor-based, so thank you, CMT, for your valuable contribution. So, in this first room, obviously, what we can see here is we have brutes instead of elites. That I do like. They're a little less formidable, at least the ones without shields. You have a few different options here, obviously. You do need to be careful, however, they do have gravity grenades, which, by the way, I'm talking like this is a walkthrough. It is not. It is just simple gameplay. Obviously, there are probably people out there who can do this mission much better than I can, who've probably at least played it a few more times and know the ins and outs. There are definitely parts of Assault on the Control Room that I still have trouble with if I don't do the cliff skip, what I call it, where basically you scale the cliff right outside the door over here and basically despawn all the enemies for the vast majority of the rest of the mission, if not the entire mission. So right now I'm using the Shredder. It does not seem to be as effective here as it was on the Pillar of Autumn. Probably just me. So we got one of the special ops brutes over here. Those guys are pretty notorious for having vortex grenades or gravity grenades. And apparently this one also has a brute shot, so yay. Man, he sounds pissed. That is definitely a Halo 2 soundbite right there. And whoa, he is coming after me. I guess it's a good thing brutes can't jump. At least not in this iteration of the game. Also, I want to apologize in advance in case my mic cuts out. I'm looking into getting a new one. This one is notorious for doing it. It's a wireless mic. So as I'm playing here, it is possible that it might cut out for a second. Not really sure what triggers that. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. Seems like the longer I record, the more likely it is to happen. So I do apologize ahead of time. So, not sure if I want to go with the Shredder here or the SMG. The SMG has more ammo, so we're just going to, I guess, go with this route for now. Not much has changed so far within the first part of this mission, at least. Most of the enemies are the same. They do have some modified weapons here, such as the Brute Plasma Pistol, which, if you don't know, shoots firebolts, and the Overcharge Shot is basically like napalm. It's pretty deadly. Do not take a hit from it. Oh, another rocket. I guess that's the Pelican. So, one thing that you want to keep in mind in this game is that the Pelicans are heavily armed with both rockets and machine guns. So, that is a good thing ultimately, but you also don't want to stand in the way of their target. So, we're going to take this a little bit slowly. I know there's an elite at the bottom. There he is. Come on. Now, I will say, I definitely love the new version of the plasma rifle in this game. The bolts look a lot more like plasma and less like paste, like in the original Halo. It's a lot more fun to use. I like the fact that the Jackals can be more distinct in terms of their rank and what weapon they're carrying based on their shield color. So we're going to move ahead a little bit. Now, if you go in the direction below, which I am going to eventually take that route, just because there's a bunch of grunts under there, I do want to get rid of them. And we have a jackal that's hiding under there, too. But there's like 6 or 7 grunts under here. Definitely want to take those guys out, because otherwise you'll get sort of cornered when you come back up to the top. Remember, there is a zealot elite at the end of this with a sword. He is quick, he is fast, and he is tough. Oh, and did I mention Relentless? He might be running for president. So, definitely be careful there. The only real easy way to take this guy out is with a plasma pistol overcharge shot, followed by a ballistic weapon. That's... Whoa! And there's a Banshee. do you love me? Probably not anymore. Sorry, bud. Had to put you down. Alright, so this might be a good time to go back up to the top. I think we've pretty much taken care of everything down there. If there were any sleepy grunts before, they are not asleep now. So I'm going to go ahead and take some of these guys out, trying to see which one has the brute plasma pistol. There's always at least one. I think that was it right there. That can be very useful against unshielded enemies, but against elites, it's not quite as effective. I've noticed sometimes it has a stun effect, but that's kind of touch and go. Usually you're just better off with a standard plasma weapon. So... Alright, moving forward, is that it? It must be. Oh, nope, there you are. So just a little recap here, in case you did not know, the battle rifle in this game is a 3-shot burst, unzoomed, just like the standard battle rifle. Zoomed is a single shot. You can switch it to 3, but it seems like the single shot is much more effective. Not only are you not wasting as many bullets, but it seems to actually have a little bit more accuracy to it. Again, I could be wrong there, so... But, alright, so we got the brute plasma rifle here. Let's see what we've got coming out that door. So it's already open. The elite's standing on the other side. Again, this guy is fast. Very difficult to outrun. You definitely can't outrun him if you're backing up. There he is. Sometimes shooting a couple of rounds off just to get his attention. And he is... Uh-oh. I am screwed. They can jump pretty high, too. I mean, this guy's done some, like, borderline magical things. I'm actually kind of lucky right now that he's not... Oh, Jesus. I am... Oh! And... Oh! Wow! That has got to be the luckiest break I have ever had against one of these guys. Let's see if he dropped a, Void's Tear. I don't think so. Oh well. They don't usually have that much ammo anyway. So, alright, let's start with the... I guess really the Needler is the only thing that has any ammo around here, so we'll go with that for now. Unless I can find my SMG anywhere. Nope. Alright. So, we're going to go ahead and I'm just going to wait for it to load, and here we go. So, not sure what's in this next room right here, if it's going to be Elites or Brutes. One of the nice things about having a large number or a nice variety of enemies in this game is it's very hard to predict what you might face versus what was in the original one. And it's a hunter. Okay, did not see that coming. All right, go, 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 Tyrant. Oh, okay, he's following me. Go faster. Must go faster. Go, 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 go. All right, there we go. That was my Jeff Goldblum impression right there. And women will inherit the earth. So now we move to the bottom floor. I'm hoping that this is like the original, where it's just sleeping grunts, or at least mostly just sleeping grunts. We can just sort of rush by here. I don't want to take too much time, because again, these rooms do get very repetitive after a while. That was a little anticlimactic. There we go. This seems like a good methodology to use for now. Oh, and that guy's definitely not asleep. Thank you, Sasquatch, for alerting me to your presence. So I'm just going to try to rush through here as quick as I can now. Apparently there are skirmishers in this room too. I'm just trying to dodge as best I can. Fortunately the door is right here. Hopefully there are no enemies on the other side, and there are not. Whew, okay. Let me get my heart back together for a second. Alright, so what have we got out here? What is new? What is different? Okay, that's the same. Okay, so yes, we have enemies fighting each other. Or I should say enemies and UNSC. There's another turret up there. Still standard for this game. Let's see. Health, that's always a good thing. And a Gauss Hog. Alright. I like where this is going. It'll be short-lived since a tank is in our near future, but still. I think it's pretty cool that we actually get to use a Gauss Hog in this game. The effects are really good. The Gauss Hog itself is pretty powerful. I mean, you could probably do the rest of the mission using this. It just wouldn't be quite as fun, and I know there's a lot more enemies coming up. A lot more than typical in the tank run. And so here we go. Our first look at not the Scorpion tank, but the Grizzly tank from Halo Wars. Someone pointed out in my sneak peek video that I referenced that this came from Halo 2. If I did say that, I don't remember saying that. Must have been a typo on my part, or a typo in speech, if you will. But no, the Grizzly tank is a tank featured in Halo Wars. Not sure if it's in Halo Wars 2 yet, but basically it's like an Uber Scorpion tank. It's got two barrels on it. This particular variant has two machine guns as well. Since this is Halo 1, obviously you control all cannons. There are no secondary drivers necessary in order to work everything. The secondary machine gun here is actually pretty powerful. Sometimes it's even a little bit more useful than the double-barreled tank shells. And so my first criticism, and again, take, you know, when I say things about, you know, criticism and whatnot, it's not because I dislike something, it's just because I care about it and would like to see it improved later on. So even though the Grizzly tank looks like a really cool concept, really what I've noticed is the having those two barrels there is kind of a mixed bag. It has a spread to it, so you're not shooting straight like you would be with a Scorpion. They can go off in all sorts of different directions, and this gets better illustrated later in CMT's personal add-on to this mission when it what all right so I'm rambling now but essentially, when things get too busy on the screen and things start to lag a little bit, it starts cutting back on the visuals. So I've noticed, and it's doing it here, you no longer see the tank shell trails. You get a better view of where the rounds are actually going, and they can go in like completely different directions in terms of where you're actually aiming it. So it's a little bit jarring. You have to get up close to guarantee your shot. Otherwise, your shoulder is just pissing into the wind. But the machine gun seems to be a lot more accurate, so that I tend to like to use a little bit more. So there are a lot of shade turrets around here. We got a couple of wraiths down. We got that Spectre down. There's a lot more opposition than in the standard assault on the control room, so it's definitely worth taking slower. But again, just like with the original, with this tank, you can have up to four passengers. Always better to have at least one with the rocket launcher. And if you can get one with a sniper rifle too, that's really fantastic. My rocket launcher guy's right there. Unfortunately, there's no way to guarantee what one will get on the tank itself. I'm hoping for right now, at least maybe he follows me down to the chasm or the tunnel right there. So that once I get out and all the soldiers jump off just because I jumped out of the tank, maybe he'll be one of the ones who gets back in. I'm hoping that's sort of how it prioritizes things, just who's more useful. And I think that guy almost rocketed me, you son of a bitch. Clearly he did not watch my Halo 2 video of the Marines hate Master Chief. Or maybe he did, and he's just following suit. So, and I don't... What is that sound? It sounds like I'm getting hit, but I'm not. Alright, so there are a couple of hunters down here. We're going to take these guys out real quick. I think I hear a Banshee. Yep, there he is. Oh, all right. Instincts kicked in. What are you thinking? Oops, sorry, dude. Taking one for the team. Or, as Negan would say, taking it like a champ. All right, so Go ahead and activate this door right here. Hopefully if the Marine followed me down here, he'll jump on as well. So we have a rocket guy. So far, aside from bad guys and weapons changes, this has been pretty much the same mission as the standard Pillar of Autumn, and I hope I'm not running people down. They're just kind of cornering me in here. Alright, do we have any more? Is it just you three? Oh, come on, dude. Take that Adderall. Focus. There we go. So now we're approaching the infamous Chasm Room. You know, it's really fun when you play this on regular Halo PC and you turn falling damage off. You can actually jump all the way down to the bottom and just see how large it is. It actually wouldn't be a bad multiplayer map if you added a few obstacles to it. So we got those guys taken out pretty quick. Not much change here so far. You've got a couple of shade turrets just like in the original one. Mostly jackals on the bridge, no surprise there. But the visuals have been updated. I do like the amber hue that they've added here. I like the level of detail. Definitely something to enjoy. If you go back and look at the original versus what you see here, there is definitely something that you're going to miss. So the visuals alone definitely make this worthwhile. But like I said, the major changes to this mission do not occur until closer to the end. So I'm going to take these guys out real quick. I don't know why he's doing an overcharge shot at the tank, because even in this mod, overcharge shots, as far as I know, well, actually, you know what? I think I could be wrong there. They might be effective against vehicles. I haven't fully tried it yet. Oh, did you miss me? There we go. Don't worry, there's enough for everybody. Like I said, the aiming to this can be a little bit jarring. And also the steering. That's what's really got me about driving this tank, is it's really easy to drive off of cliffs, off of bridges, far more than it was with the standard Scorpion. So I don't know if that was done intentionally, giving more tank-like controls, pun not intended. So that, you know, it balances out the firepower that it dishes. So I think we've got all the enemies taken care of here. I noticed one of the guys had a focus rifle. I want to see if I can pick that up. That's definitely a more suitable weapon. Let's see, where is that thing? To a plasma pistol. Let's see, is it around here? I know you're... Oh, there we go. Much better. Like I said, unfortunately, there are no charging stations like in the previous two missions, so what you have is what you're going to get until you come across another one, at least. Alright, so I think we're about ready to roll out. Oh, see what I mean about the driving? Very clunky, and not sure how I feel about that. I love the concept of the Grizzly tank. It definitely needs a few tweaks, though, just to make it a little bit more fun to use in combat. Keep in mind, this is not a multiplayer vehicle, so having a weapon that's overpowered really doesn't hurt anyone. It just makes it more fun for you, the player. Alright, so we're going to deal with this real quick. What is he bitching about? Oh, okay, we got lots of enemies up here, including flying grunts, apparently. One with a binary rifle, What am I thinking? Close enough. But because it is kind of like the binary rifle in Halo 5. I'm sorry, the focus rifle. So we're going to start our charge to the end of the tunnel right here. Trying to take out as many bad guys as I can, mostly because I want to put most of my focus on the Phantom dropship that's going to come down as we reach the tunnel's opening. But I like how all this is like really dark until you get closer to the top. Just has got this night tunnel thing happening there. I like it. Which, by the way, that was also in the original version of this map. So, oh, and there's the Phantom. I'm not going to get there in time, it looks like. There's another focus rifle jackal. Let's see if I can actually get this thing shot down. Obviously, he's already dropping things off. Oh, and we got it. And it's just sitting there. Odds are the particle effects. Oh, warped out, or it turned into a specter, or shadow. I think that's what they call it in this particular variant. But like I said, when things start getting really busy on the screen with the particle effects, you're going to start missing things like that, like the Phantom exploding. Instead of doing that, it just sort of like plopped down in the snow and disappeared. You can't see the trails of the tank shells or anything like that. Again, not sure if that's a byproduct of the game or if it's my video card or what the deal is. Because keep in mind, this game came out, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, 2003, Halo PC. The mod just came out this year, so... You know, they've been working on it for a long time, but you would think that a game that old would not have a problem running on an Alienware laptop. That was, let's see, I've had that one for 4.5 years now. And it's been good to me, I will say that. I'm gonna trash that thing. Here comes some more, looks like brutes and elites? Jackals, maybe? Ugh. Yeah, definitely some brutes there. The gravity grenade definitely gave that away. Now, what I hear is in later missions, the plan with the, not the special ops elites, but the strike team elites, the ones wearing black suits, since other elites in this game already throw grenades, they're going to allow those to throw gravity grenades. That could be trouble. Should be interesting. But we won't find that out until next year. So, and that, as CMT, if you are listening right now, I cannot wait for you to release the next half of this campaign. It's been excellent so far. Cannot wait to see what you do with the Flood and the Sentinels. I hear you have a lot of different things in store, and it's a special ops pair of hunters. And a ghost. Man, that guy snuck up on me quick. Oh, sorry to... There we go. That's right, you say it. Exactly what I was thinking. So by the way, yes, you can pick up those special ops cannons. Essentially what they are shade turrets. So I'm not sure if this makes the special ops hunters more dangerous or just different. But it certainly makes them more interesting. So unfortunately, this is the last part where you can actually take the tank. I don't know if there's a way to get the tank on the other side. If there is, please let me know in the comments below or hit me up on Twitter, because I am legitimately curious. The next section can be a little bit difficult. Yes, technically, you can grab the invisibility and just run for it. All the Marine forces in this area. But that seems to be a hit or miss type thing if you're trying to do this with no deaths. So... We got more hunters down here, so they've definitely packed this mission with hunters. What I've noticed throughout this mod is there seems to be an abundance of them. Not quite sure how I feel about that. It's at least cool that we have three different variants of them, but they've definitely appeared in places where I'm not quite sure if they belong there or not. Again, just a small little criticism there, but overall I really am enjoying everything that's been done here. So we got another dropship coming in. See if I can shoot this one down or if I'm going to get screwed over by the Grizzly tanks. Aim. Yeah, looks like I'm going to be screwed over by the Grizzly tanks. Aim. Come on. See if I can blow this thing up. Oh, nice. Destructible dropships obviously is a definite plus in features in this game. Something I would have loved to have seen in Halo 2 like it was supposed to be, but we did not end up getting it until Halo 3. So there's your invisibility cloak over there on the left-hand side. If you want, you can use that to basically rush to the end of this particular segment, but I like to try to fight it out at least a little bit. Now, you do have to be a little bit careful. I'm trying to draw out what's in there, which is a cloaked elite with an energy sword. And again, this guy is fast, and he will shred your troops just like that. So I can't seem to get his attention, so I guess I'm gonna have to go in there. Ugh. All right, so I guess we'll use the focus rifle, one of the main reasons we brought this along. Try to level this guy pretty quickly. Very effective against elites. There he is. This guy is tough. This guy is quick too. Trying to help you. There we go. And there's a skirmisher there too. He's hiding out. Oh, and a jackal. Okay. Do not remember this from the original one. I could be wrong. It's been a while since I played the Assault on the Control Room. In fact, I think the last time I played Halo Combat Evolved was back in 2012 when I uploaded the anniversary edition to my channel, the legendary walkthrough for it. Alright, so eventually we're probably going to come back for that rocket launcher. For now, I'm just going to kind of sit up here, try to snipe as many enemies as I can, try to clear a path for my Marines to give me a hand.
Marines, hold your positions. We'll handle those guns.
Master Chief, we should scale the ridge and get below those stationary guns.
Okay, so... got lots... Man, my aim is terrible! That's what happens when you use a bedspread as a... mouse pad. Alright, so... we're gonna take these guys out real quick. I don't remember a shade turret being there in the original one. So, fortunately, enemies aren't gonna come down here. So you have this place to use as cover. I don't know what the trigger is to send the Marines up there. I don't want them to go up there yet because they're going to get hosed completely by Covenant fire. And I can already hear a carbine up there too. By the way, second most useful weapon in this game might be tied with the first. Like I said, this one is very, very close to being in use with the regular pistol. Only you have tons and tons of ammunition for it. And like any other plasma weapon, it can stun the enemy and has effects on enemy shielding. So, let's see, we're gonna go ahead and take these guys out bit by bit. Skirmishers are a little bit annoying, but you know, if any game could have used them and made them unique, I would say Halo Combat Evolved is definitely the game for it. Because after this game, you get introduced to Jackal Snipers and Ranger Jackals, and so skirmishers no longer seem that unique, except for the fact that they're just very dodgy, as opposed to just standard Jackals. So, good job CMT for making the skirmishers work so well in this game. They are still annoying as hell to fight, don't get me wrong, but they are a good addition, and I think I just hit puberty again. My voice keeps cracking. Alright, so we got brutes up here too. There are a ton of enemies. Is that a brute plasma pistol or plasma rifle? Plasma rifle. Okay, so it's not that big of a deal. The brute plasma rifle shoots slower than the regular plasma rifle, but the individual rounds are far more powerful. Which I'm not sure if that's better than the Halo 2 version or not. I kind of like the faster version. Let's see, there we go. So, there we go. I think I've cleared out most of the enemies. Alright, so now I'm going to go ahead and get a rocket launcher. I'm going to come back for the focus rifle later, but right now I want to go ahead and take out those guns, and I believe that there is a Banshee that will eventually come and try to attack as well. So let's see. I wonder why I can't pick this thing up, unless I automatically have one. The health mod for your armor. Okay. So we have this for now. Total of 8 shots for the rocket launcher. I don't think this one homes in. I've seen in other Halo mods where they have a rocket launcher and a missile launcher, where the missile launcher actually locks on to aircraft. I do not think this is among those, though. So, let's see. Although I do love the look of the CMT version of the rocket launcher. Definitely a lot cooler looking than the original. You can actually see both barrels at once. I think that's awesome. Too bad you can't use them both at the same time. Okay, so I think I got that guy. I'm looking for the Banshee right now. Just waiting for him to try to dive bomb down here. Not even try to shoot at you, just like plow into you. Okay, so we're gonna try to get this guy. So the ghost is there as well. And my Marines are getting their asses handed to them as we speak. Oh, and I hear the Banshee. Where is he? Come on. You can't hide forever. Where are you? This is making me a little nervous. Okay, well, there's a Spectre. Looks like he's trying to kiss the ground. I'm not really sure what's going on there. A little Cinemax action. They are really dodgy. I'm like wasting so many rockets right now just trying to hit this thing. And I'm on point. Okay, that was just the rocket itself. I think that Marine had a better chance of hitting this, the Shadow with this grenade than I do with the rocket launcher. This is ridiculous. Okay, time to get more ammo and... Oh, Jesus! Man, that... That Banshee is just determined to use the hull of its craft to smash the crap out of me. I think that pilot works for Al-Qaeda. Alright, so let's see if there is... Alright, so we can do this. See if I can actually shoot that thing down. I would prefer just to clear this area out. If this fails, I'll just go back and get the active camo and just run for it. I would prefer not to do that, but it isn't. If you're speedrunning, that really is the best way to do things. You guys know me. Typically, I don't concern myself with speedrunning. I think we actually hit him that time. So let's see. Alright, maybe it takes two rockets to take this thing out. Yep, alright, I think we got him that time. So we have two rockets left. Let's see if I can get this Banshee to cooperate. Not entirely sure. Where did he go? I hear him. I've noticed the Banshee can actually come back into this area. So whatever the tunnel is above, that can be used to actually go back and forth. I wish I could figure out get the tank up there and get that down here, because that'd be pretty awesome as well. Although I'm pretty sure it cannot take this ridge right here. So can't find the Banshee. Not worth it at this point. Sounds like he's doing a great job of trashing his own vehicle, so we're just going to go ahead and make a run for it. I've already taken care of most of the enemies here, and now you can't say that I left my Marines behind. So, alright, so now we're heading into what I consider one of the more annoying parts of the mission. This is where you come across a ton of those little circular rooms. It just gets really repetitive after a while. Jesus. Okay, so they're probably going to follow me in here. Maybe, maybe not. I'm going to wait just a second to see if they follow me in, or they go the other way. Looks like that Banshee's trying to make its way in here too, and don't kid yourself, it can happen. They can do it. Okay, so at least we have another room full of sleeping enemies. I like how the soundtrack just stopped mid-sentence right there. That's awesome. Okay, so... We'll take out a few of these guys at least, just in case they wake up. I'm not completely swarmed by grunts. My guess is there's probably jackals or elites or brutes patrolling the outskirts of this area, so at least that part was fairly simple. Now we gotta go up. Maybe we gotta go, I think, through two rooms? Maybe it's just one. One or two rooms, I forget. And then we go to our double bridge area. That one's actually kind of cool on two betrayals, just because you usually have flood on one side. Jesus, dude. There you go. Oh, he's got a brute plasma rifle. That's pretty cool. So just because you had flood on one side, Covenant on the other, you got to see him trade fire back and forth, and the flood make these like god launches across the chasm to the other bridge. It's one of the coolest moments in the game. It's when you actually see a threat that's bigger than the Covenant that even they just flat out can't handle. So I can't wait to see what CMT's take on that is in their version. Which again, hopefully we'll be seeing next year. It looks like that guy has a Brute plasma pistol too. So we're going to go ahead and spend a grenade on him. It's a grenade well spent. Those things can be pretty lethal, as can that. So we're going to back up just a little bit. We still haven't really found any ammo for... the battle rifle here, which I'm starting to get a little concerned about because we're running low. Not really sure what kind of weapon I'm going to replace it with, because carbines have not been common in this mission as opposed to the last couple of missions. Same with the focus rifle. So, for those of you who wanted to see what it was like for me to go through assault in the control room, granted, this is not the original one, but there you go. And yeah, I've died by this guy before. I completely forgot in the original that there was a Zealot Elite hiding back there, and by the time I found out, you know, boom, here he comes, he starts chasing me, I try to run back to the elevator, he usually catches up, and that's all there is to it. They are very powerful in this game. In fact, this is the only game I can remember in Halo history where I was genuinely afraid of Zealots. So I'm definitely trying to take this part very lightly right here. Try not to waste too much ammo, because obviously I don't have very much left, both with this and the focus rifle. There we go. That's better. It's like having a shotgun attached to your machine gun. Alright, so I'm gonna go back just to see if maybe there's some battle rifle ammo in that cluster right there. I think that's mostly for the assault rifle. Unfortunately. Now, not sure what the others are for, maybe the DMR. Maybe that was their intent for you to pick up the DMR at this point in the mission, but like I said, I like having the grenade launcher secondary option. The only downside to having that is you cannot toss grenades while this particular weapon is equipped. Uh-oh. I know what that sound means. Come here. There you go. Grunts were so much... Whoa. Okay. There's a needler there. Grunts are so much cuter in these games because they had the little, you know, the gas masks on. They look like little pacifiers. Whereas in later games, they kind of look like ogres. So not really sure what the inspiration behind that was, but I definitely miss these grunts right here. So we're going to take these guys out. There's a lot of them. Wow. So if I remember correctly, there should be hunters on the other side of the bridge. It's either in this one or the next one. No, I think it's the second time you go across the bridge. Or when you're on the opposite bridge that hunters appear. So let's see, you're going to take out these guys real quick since I'm running really low on ammo. Got grunts on the other side, so I got to make every shot count here. Fortunately, they're making it pretty easy for me. Okay, so at least we have a lot of ammo left in the focus rifle, so we can deal with the elites pretty effectively. Love the coloring on these guys, too. I don't want to spend too much of this ammo, because we have a lot of elites in the next area as well. Okay. Let's try this again. He's being pretty dodgy. There we go. Take out those guys first. If you were to look down, you've got a nice little view of just how high up you are and where you came from. I would highly recommend watching that first step. There we go. That ought to deal with that. See if I can actually... Alright. You know, I'll just use a regular grenade. He ain't going anywhere anyway. Okay, so we have more grunts on this side. That guy's freaking out. Not that I blame him. His best friend just got turned into Swiss cheese. Another where? Alright, so I'm not sure what's about to come outside this door. I think, if I'm not mistaken, it's active camo elites. Let's see if I'm right or wrong here. Nope! Not yet. I think that's the next bridge. Oh! Try not to waste my ammo here. Like I said, gotta make every shot count. There's still one of you guys left. Eh, you're fine. So, I'll use the... plasma rifle for right now. Might come back later if need be. But right now this needs to be my primary weapon because I have almost zero ammo left in my battle rifle. And this is actually a very effective weapon against, or a very effective weapon against elites. At least it was in Halo Combat Evolved. Not so much in other Halo games. That guy was straight up charging me. Man, you've got balls, dude. I don't know, maybe he had a stick of dynamite strapped to him. Alright, so we're going to move a little bit forward here. I'm going to take that needler with me just in case we could use it later. Oh, more ammo. Okay, so let me go back and see if my battle rifle's still there or if it despawned. Hopefully it did not despawn because we could definitely use that as well. I'm going to take this needler with me as a trash weapon because I might want to use the plasma rifle later just in trying to conceive or... What am I looking for? There we go. Trying to conserve ammo for the focus rifle because I know at least in one of these rooms there are a bunch of active camo elites with energy swords, and that's really what I want to use it for the most. So we're going to proceed forward. I think this is the first area with an elongated hallway. I think this one just has mostly grunts and jackals. I'm not sure if there are any standard elites in there. Thank God. Okay, so we finally have a full battle rifle again. That I desperately needed. Was not quite sure what weapon I would replace it with, since at this point, human weapons are going to be harder to come across. So I don't see any elites here, so I think it's primarily just grunts and jackals. Nothing wrong with that. Let's see. The rocket launcher here could be a good idea for later. Let's see there. Yeah, I like to have this instead. What I'm going to do is I'm going to come back for the rocket launcher just so I can deal with the hunters in the next area. That'll definitely come in handy. For now, I'm going to try to save some of my ammo. This is obviously an easy-to-come-by weapon, so, you know, plow the road with it. In fact, I don't really think I've used the plasma rifle very much in this game so far, so why not? Just going to mow these guys down real quick. Again, just trying to conceal battle rifle ammo here just because I don't know when the next time is going to be where I can pick it up. Yes, I have played through this mission once already, but I didn't go through it in great detail because, again, I'm not making a walkthrough here, just a gameplay video. But I wanted to be at least a little bit more prepared this time. So, let's see. Grab the focus rifle for now. Or should I go with the rocket launcher? I'm not exactly sure. Decisions, decisions. Whichever I go with, it means I have to come back later and pick the other one up. So, I could weapon juggle if I really wanted to. That is an option. I'm just afraid that if I do it too much, it'll despawn the weapon or it'll fall off the map or something like that. I have seen it happen before. So, I just want to go into this fully prepared. Okay, let's see. There we go. Kept hitting the wrong button there. Ooh, epic stick! Ew. That sounded like at least a triple kill. Okay, now what else is through here? Are they bunching up in the middle, or are they going towards the other side? Or are they trying to flank me? What's going on here? Where are they? I know some of them are probably hiding in that second floor up there. For those of you who don't know, in Two Betrayals, that is a really, really common place for Flood to hide. Actually, Flood to hide sounds like something you would poison someone with. Alright, so let's see. I think he's probably around there. See, I want to get this place at least a little bit clear so I can come back later for the focus rifle without having to deal with too much enemy opposition. Oh, there we go. So for now, I'm just going to go through here. The hunters are going to be on the opposite bridge. So if you can take them out, that's great. If not, it's not that big of a deal. It just means you have to be extra cautious when you're dealing with the enemies on this side. So you don't get accidentally blindsided by a hunter fuel rod round. Okay, lots of commotion here. And we have a brute as well. Okay, there's the first hunter. I think I completely missed that shot. I've got to be really careful here. Do not have that many rocket launcher rounds. Okay, that's one hit. I'm not sure how many rounds it takes to kill these particular hunters. So, let's see. I think I got him, which means I have two left. Let's see if that hits. Nope, I missed him. That was a direct hit to the face, and he's still standing. See if, well, unfortunately, one thing you have to remember about the grenades here is that they are not straight shots. So I just basically wasted three grenades. That's fantastic. Well, at least I can go back later and pick some more up. So right now, since I'm going back there anyway, I'm going to go ahead and get some more ammo and go ahead and retrieve my focus rifle. Let's see if the enemies have retreated or despawned or... No, they're still there, but I think they're clustered up in the middle somewhere. So we can probably just scoot on by without any problems here, at least hopefully. And we're just going to move along, dancing to the music here while I'm hearing that. Well, dancing as much as a crippled guy can do anyway. Mainly just involves tapping the cane on the floor. So let's see, that trip didn't take too long. Not too far out of the way. I'll take it. Let's see, can we get more ammo? Is there more ammo? Well, crap. Okay, so I just wasted a couple of grenade rounds for nothing. But that's okay, because at least I have my trusty focus rifle. This place is actually pretty scary when you come back in through two betrayals, because there's a flood that appears at the other end of the hallway with a rocket launcher, and you have no idea when this guy is going to shoot at you either. I mean, those guys are complete dicks. Almost as bad as Jackal snipers in Halo 2. Maybe not quite as dickish as that, but it's definitely somewhere on that same plane of dickishness. Alright, so we're going through. Back on the bridge. So now we just have to be a little bit more careful. At least we have one hunter down. So it's not too terrible. I mean, we can easily dodge his blast. There's a lot of cover here, so I'm not that concerned. It's when you have two hunters that it can be a problem, because they can position themselves differently, and then one bit of cover, it may not help you at all. So I'm going to take these guys out too. Eliminate as much of the opposition as I can. I think that's the hunter. Alright. My aim is so terrible. I apologize in advance, guys. Actually, that's not an advanced apology, because it's already happened, so I just flat out apologize. But at least I'm having a lot of fun, and you will too if you download this mod. I am putting a link in the description below of where you can get this. Definitely highly encourage it. I'm not sure if you can install Halo Custom Edition without having a copy of Halo PC. CMT community, if you're watching, you want to comment on that below, definitely let me know too, because I'm kind of curious about that myself. So we're just going to kind of fly through here as quick as I can. There we go. Really didn't want to waste too much ammo. Glad I got a new focus rifle out of that. A little spur of the moment. That may have looked cool, but that was just completely luck-based right there. I did not intend for that to happen. Didn't think I'd actually live through it. What do you know? But at least we're on a roll here. We are getting towards the final part of the mission. So we're pretty much almost done with these circular rooms right here, thankfully. So you're going through here. The next hallway is really why I wanted the focus rifle to begin with, just because of all those active camo elites with the energy swords. Those guys are a pain in the ass. I don't know if you remember the assault, the Truth and Reconciliation video. Oh my gosh, I had to restart that mission a couple of times just because they would like kill Captain Keys when you were coming back through and going back to the control room. They're right there. And of course, I try to do these things without dying if I can. So there's our first guy. Oh, he got dangerously close there. Where is he? There's our next one. I think there's at least one more with an energy sword, if I'm not mistaken. Unlike Zealots, however, they do not drop Void's Tear, at least as far as I know. I haven't seen one do it yet. I think it's strictly just Zealots. If you take down their shields, they'll whip out their Void's Tear, and that sounded a lot more sexual than I was intending for it to be. Alright, so I'm basically just trying to fire shots here. I think there's one or two more of these elites left. Yeah, there's two of them. Very difficult to see in this game. But I'm glad we have a hose-type weapon that makes it at least a little bit easier. So we got three down, one to go. So I guess there's four in this room. Only one has a sword, thankfully. Because those guys are a pain in the butt. One reason why I like using the focus rifle against these guys is you can just hose around until you can see their shields flare up. And then you can just, like, you know, just keep boiling them as much as you possibly can. So we're going to finish this up here. There's one circular room left. And then I think we get to the... Oh, hunters. I don't know what kind they are, but if I remember correctly from the original game, all you have to do is just go around here. You do not have to fight them. I don't think there's a consequence for that, unlike in playing the mission Blue Team in Halo 5, where if you don't kill the first two hunters you come across, you have to deal with them at the end of the mission. Thank you, 343 Industries. So, oh, there's still these guys left. I'm going to try to just run by here real quick, trying to save my ammo. No reason to deal with this. Resistance appears to be increasing. If I had a super weapon, I guess I would be President of the United States. So, now we're getting into the new part that's DMT design. As you can see, we're going really, really, really far down here. In the original game, this was where you would go outside and try to steal that Banshee to make a final break for the control center. Or you'd have to fight your way through another few rooms or another couple of circular rooms before getting to the ground level and getting your ass handed to you by a couple of wraiths. So we got this little segment right here. You got some broods, got some grunts. Some of these guys are asleep, but this won't last very long, especially with a grunt on that shade turret right there. So we're gonna take this nice and slow. Use a gravity grenade. Just go ahead and destroy that shade turret entirely. That's the best way to go here. Now, granted, you just woke up the entire room, but since all the other enemies are on the ground level, I don't think they can get up here. Not that big of a problem. You have elevation to your advantage, so that's what we're going to be doing from here on out until we can get outside. That guy dropped like a fly. Oh, okay, run. That's a cluster grenade. They're not that powerful, but I mean, if one hits you dead on, then, well, it will do its job. So, let's see if I can return the favor. And it apparently worked. So I think we may have one more brute down there. I want to take this guy out as quick as I can. Then I think it's just mostly jackals and grunts. Lots of needlers. That signature purple shield that the jackals have. There we go. Brute is down. Rest should be fairly simple. I really shouldn't be needing any focus rifle ammo in this mission at this point, just because of how the rest of this is supposed to play out. Maybe I'll need something at the very end, but again, time will tell. But mainly you're going to have a tank from here on out, so I'm not really that concerned. And gosh, that is brutal. Oh, the imagery. It's like watching Game of Thrones in 2552. I imagine that we'd have similar results in that scenario. Maybe the brutes are the White Walkers. Or the Flood, I don't know. So they're asleep. I'm going to try to sneak over here. This is an entirely new section. Not sure if this is supposed to be outdoors or if this is just strictly underground, because there's no light coming in. Like, it's not bright down here at all. So I'm wondering if this is just like one big cave. So I'm going to go ahead and grab this ghost right now. No one is aware of my presence, and we're going to see if we can go ahead and sneak over and grab the scorpion, or the, sorry, the grizzly tank over here by the pelican. Not sure how the pelican actually managed to get down here. Oh, this is indoors. I see the, shoot, you know, I always get stalactites and stalagmites mixed up if I don't have Google on me at the moment. I'm going to see if I can hijack this vehicle real quick. Yes, this is a reminder that you can hijack vehicles in this Halo CE mod. I don't think I've actually driven a Shadow yet in any of my gameplay videos, so here you go. I just don't have a gunner on there. So now I've got a nice health pack there, got the grizzly tank, and now we're pretty much going to coast on through. Now, as you can see, the particles are really starting to lose their way. I can't even see what I'm hitting for the most part right now, just because there's so much going on, so much that's new, so much that wasn't intended to be in the game, but still feels very organic to the original Halo tone. So, way to go, CMT, for that one. I'm going to go ahead and take this carbine for now. Might need that later. That was not wise, my friend. Alright, so this is where you got to be extra careful, because these bridges are slippery, and because of the way the tank controls are designed here, it's very easy to fall off. No second chances there. It just happens. Once it starts going over, it's going to go over. And odds are you're going to jump out on the side that is on the cliff side. So, got to be careful there. So, again, this is an entirely new section. We have a Wraith over there. We've got some shade turrets. Unfortunately, when you're this far away, the accuracy of the Grizzly tank tends to be not so great. So, take with that what you will. If you're feeling brave, you can probably fast rush the Wraith. But remember that in this campaign, they do have secondary guns. So I'm going to keep driving straight. See if I can move this thing. See if I can try to push this off. It's like a giant styrofoam. So I'm going to see if I can push this off. Alright, so we're getting a little bit closer here. I mean, I guess I can still, you know, keep pushing if I really want to. I don't know. So we're almost there, almost there. Just trying to take my time here a little bit. Thinking about just doing a fast rush, but at the same time, there's three Wraiths over there. I think at least one of them's an anti-air Wraith, not entirely sure. But they don't seem too intent on attacking me. They're just kind of sitting there and taking it. I'm trying to keep my eye out for any vague particle effects that I can pick up just to see that the Wraith is down. Alright, so it's still moving, so obviously it's not down yet. It's also difficult to tell if I actually hit it, so I think I did that time. Again, when the particle effects get too intense, it gets really difficult to see things. So we're just going to drive on through, trying to be careful here. As you can see, it's very, very close. I was very close to tipping over right there. That is never fun. So I'm just taking this nice and slow. Listen to the soundtrack here, though. That definitely was not a part of the original Halo game, but it's very, very pretty. Obviously, a lot of love went into this. Hey, I would be very interested to see, and CMT, if you're listening to this right now, if you're going to actually include this particular segment in Two Betrayals, because obviously, if you're going back in reverse, from this mission, you can't really do what they did in the original Two Betrayals. So you're going to have some sort of a tank run there too. Maybe it's why it's taking them some extra time, just because they have to figure out how they're going to redo the objectives. Because that will certainly be interesting. So we have more Wraiths up here, and apparently some hunters that want a little action themselves. We'll take care of them real quick. So we have a few more enemies over here, trying to mop up as much as I can. Got a few hunters in this area. And that is a special ops hunter. So they are definitely out in force in this mission. Oh, and it's an anti-air raid. I guess if you wanted to, you could possibly hijack that. I think I'm just going to stick with the Grizzly for now. The music just sounds very epic. Sounds like something you would hear in a Halo game. Especially when you're this far into it. Oh, and we have a Brute. Like I said, the chain guns are very effective here, so... definitely don't underestimate those. Where are you? There you are. Oh, you had shields. That's why you resisted so well. There we go. I just tungsten strike you, my friend. Alright, so we're starting our final approach, essentially. This is kind of where you saw me in my sneak peek video, or at least right before. No, this is not the same gameplay. This is something entirely different. Would not do that to you guys. But basically, this is like the little tunnel that you went through earlier in the mission. Only this time you've got a lot of enemies, got a lot of waves of tanks and hunters. Couldn't tell if there was someone else in there or not. Alright, so even more hunters. They are throwing everything but the kitchen sink at you. Okay, so I don't even know why I feel threatened by these guys. The tank is in perfectly good shape. I guess mainly because of what's coming up. There's quite a bit of chaos. Sorry about that, in the next area. Kind of cool that we got an extra tank segment. If you remember in the original campaign, you only got to drive the Scorpion tank one time in the entire game. After that, the only time you got to play it or use it was in multiplayer. And that's when everyone hates you. So I think that was the last bit, unless there's one more. I think we're almost at the cave entrance. We are going up a long way. This feels pretty endless at this point. Oh, no, never mind, more enemies and a wraith. Oh, they got sucked into their own vortex. And again! Thanks for taking care of yourselves, buddies. There we go. Almost there. Wraith is down. Flipping it like styrofoam packing. And we're almost to the end here, I believe. There we go. Okay, so this is the last major... I'm at such a loss of words right now. Sorry. This is the final push to the tower where you get to the control room. I actually like this method better than the one Bungie did because it makes it seem... This seems like something that's a bit more epic to coming... when you're approaching something that's just so important. As opposed to just, boom, you go outside a door... You got one little box canyon type deal thing, and that's it. You would think there'd be a much more epic path type thing going on here. But it's good the Marines beat you here, at least in part. It does kind of make you wonder why they needed the Chief at all, if they could do this on their own. Or if they could make it this far on their own. And for that matter, why'd they drop the Chief off so early on? If they could have dropped him off near the end. You know what? I'm looking too deep into this. This is just for fun. Gotta remember that. So, we don't have many Marines with us right now, but at least we have the best ones that you can have. That is one with a rocket launcher and one with a sniper rifle. Again, you can pick those guns up if you want to. Not a lot of point, in my personal opinion, based on how the rest of the mission plays out. So we get more brutes up here. I'm thinking that tower thing's some sort of Covenant communication device, but I could be wrong. Man, look at the blood that's just like spouting out of that. Oh, that's kind of sad. Alright, so there we go. We're gonna go down there, then take a left, go back up to the top. And then we should be at the, what they call the shrine. Let's see, so we got the tank, the rest of this should be a cakewalk, but I love these nice big open areas they've created. Just lots of intense battles. I wish there were more Marines in this area right here. Just the bigger the battle, the cooler it is. Alright, so I'm going to try not to slip and fall. But it seems like this tank always wants to go exactly where I don't want it to go. Okay, so it looks like we're almost there. Going to take out these guys real quick. I think my Marine's better at this than I am. Okay, we're just going to mow these guys down real quick. If I'm not mistaken, I think there's an anti-air wraith up there as well. There he is. Might be more than one. Yeah, there we go. Now you're driving like me. Of course, that was a standard wraith. That's right. Poor little guy drives like he came from New Jersey. Alright, so what? Well, and we have a shadow. This really does feel like an epic final stand right here. Like this makes a little bit more sense than what Bungie had in theirs. But again, that's not to criticize the original assault on the controller room. You know I love it. There's the anti-air wraith. Okay, I knew there was one up here somewhere. Fortunately, those fuel rod blasts can only go but so far before they dissipate. That's a definite plus. And I'm being hammered by brutes now, too. Alright. Not sure who to make my top priority here. So I want to keep my Marines alive. Man, there are a ton of enemies here. Would have been kind of cool if Marines could also drive in this game. That way you could have like a couple of different tanks. This sort of does remind me of that battle in Halo 3 when you're on the Ark and eventually you've got to fight the Scarab. So if the Marines could drive here and have like extra vehicular support, just it would be awesome. Okay, so there's the tower right there. You see that part right there on the that land bridge? Over there on the left is where you would be coming from in the regular game, and I'm wondering if basically we just made a big circle in terms of the map itself. Not that I'm criticizing that. If I had a flying vehicle, I'd find out, but this is pretty epic right here, so. But it would be kind of cool to see what's up there. I imagine we're probably not going to see very many Banshees at this point. I don't remember seeing any Banshees this far into the mission, but I could be wrong. So things are starting to get a little choppy just because of all the action that's going on here, but this looks pretty awesome. I will definitely give credit where credit is due. And for the music. Okay, so we have a pair of hunters there. There's also another pair on the other side as well. And a wraith that I completely forgot about. Whoops. Ouch! Okay, direct hit there. Right back at you, buddy. Alright, Mr. Grunt. He's doing probably the smartest thing he can right now by hiding, but... Okay, doesn't take him but so far. Yes, we already took care of the Wraith, friend. Like I said, that Marine's better at this than I am, sadly. So let's go to the other side now and see if we can go deal with the other pair of hunters. Try to do as much here with the tank as I can, because obviously I can't take it with me up the spire. And that's when things start getting interesting. gonna go ahead and take these guys out. Like I said, trying to eliminate as much of the competition as possible. I have a plan as far as how I'm going to scale the spire, even though I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to encounter. I didn't play this mission the entire way through when I was doing sort of a rough sketch. I got to around this area and then stopped. So what's left will be a complete surprise. What I will do is there is a ghost right beside me under the bridge right there, as you can see, that I am planning on taking with me. So I have a vehicle that I can actually do. Now granted, the ghost in this particular mod do a horrible job of splattering, but I have infinite plasma ammo, and that's really all I'm really looking for at this point. Or if I just need to speed by something. Alright, so there's not a lot more we can do with the Grizzly tank at this point. So I'm going to go ahead and grab the ghost. At least we have a decently filled carbine. It is less than 50%, but better than it could be. So we're going to go up here. The ghost is the only vehicle small enough to be able to do this. And it looks like there's a Marine that's shooting rockets at me. Not sure if that's going to work out. I appreciate what you're trying to do, buddy, but you might get me killed. The sniper rifle dude makes a lot more sense here. You, on the other hand, do not. But at least they added Marines to this part, because originally when you're going up the spire, there are none, if my memory serves me correctly, in the original assault on the control room. I know I'm probably going to get a lot of dislikes for this, but other Marines freaking out, but he might accidentally kill me, so I'm going to purposely down him. Don't worry, he did a great job. He has seen the top of the mountain, and he shall be treated like he is a god. He regrets nothing, and few men have lived as, or have, My brain's completely fried. He has lived as few men dare to dream. Thank you! Wow. The fact that it took me like 5 minutes to get that out makes it just that much less appealing. You're welcome, Red versus Blue fans. Oh, honor guards! Nice touch! Have not seen them in this mission yet. They're not any different than standard elites, but it does make it pretty symbolic that they would place them here, so good job, CMT community, I like that. Well, this method seems to be working so far. So yep, we can get the ghost all the way up here. That's great. And oh shoot, we got lots of shade turrets. Not sure how this is going to pan out. If I should take them all out or if I should just speed all the way up. Yeah, this may not be as great as an idea as I was hoping for. Yeah, I'm already getting my ass handed to me. Alright, we gotta take these guys out. Definitely that elite. Alright, so I got the carbine and a little bit left for the focus rifle here, so let's see what we can do to take these guys out. Where are you? Whoop. How do I want to make this work? I could always go down and get the rocket launcher if I really wanted to. Alright, so we have two honor guards now. Alright. Where are you? Oh, sweet! That's why I love the grunts. They tell you if you actually won. So one elite is down. Oh, that guy's too fast. So we'll just finish him off with a focus rifle. That should take care of the elites. Now we can start dealing with the shade turrets. Okay, I guess you want to go first. Done deal. Now you. And that one's already empty. So you. Don't worry, I'm getting there. There's plenty to go around. Okay, that made things a little bit more simple. Just a little bit more. So I'm going to go ahead and take my trusty half-melted ghost. Gosh, Chief, where'd you get this thing? Target? Alright, so... coming back. That's all for the turrets, thankfully. Alright. And we are really high up now. So I'm going to hit this. Enemy should be on the other side. I'm going to run like a mofo. Now, can we drive all the way through? Nope, because there's another locked door. Definitely was not expecting that. Alright, so we're going to go down a little bit. Just going to have to take these guys out. Definitely don't want to screw up too much here because we are on the final stretch. Looks like mostly just grunts and elites. Elites being honor guards here. So we're almost done with this. But I barely have any ammo left. There might be ammo with that little spire thing, the tower, but that might take a little long to get to. I think we have enough that we can deal with the enemies. We are running on bare bones here, but I'm fairly confident I can get this done. Ugh. Keep hitting scenery. Alright, switch back and forth. Still one honor guard left. Not enough ammo to really deal with him, I don't think. Oh, sweet, I was wrong. So basically, we are finishing with almost no ammo. And we have one more honor guard, it looks like. Let's see if I can actually grenade him. Did that actually get him? Nope. No ammo there. Let's see if this does anything. Oh, sweet! Using every last bit of ammo here. Wow, so we finished with, I think, one grenade left. 4% of my carbine rounds. Just in case there's anything else in store, I'm going to go ahead and take the ghost with me. Well, that wraps up the CMT series. Sorry, let me do that again. Well, that wraps up my playthrough of CMT's Halo Combat Evolved. Single player version 3 part 1. Again, part 2 should be released at some point next year. Cannot wait to play that. Guys, I hope you really enjoyed this series so far. Don't forget to try this out yourself. Links are below in terms of how you can download this and try it out for yourself. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button for videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. You can follow me on Facebook and Twitter as well. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll catch you right back here on Wednesday. And as always, I am the Tyrant, signing off.
This is it. Halo's control center. Terminal, try there.
You all right?
Never been better. You can't imagine the wealth of information. The knowledge, so much, so fast. It's glorious.
So, what sort of weapon is it?
What are you talking about?
Let's stay focused. Halo, how do we use it against the Covenant?
This ring isn't a cudgel, you barbarian. It's something else. Something much more important. The Covenant were right. This ring... it's Forerunner. Give me a second to access. Yes, the Forerunner built this place, what they called a fortress world, in order to... No, that can't be. Oh, those Covenant fools. They must have known. There must have been signs.
Slow down. You're losing me.
The Covenant found something, buried in this ring, something horrible, and now they're afraid.
Something buried? Where?
The Captain. We've got to stop the Captain.
Keys?
Weapons cache he's looking for. It's not really... We can't let him get inside.
I don't understand.
There's no time. Get out of here, find Keys, stop him. Before it's too late!